because I am finally done with all of my thyroid cancer appointments that caused me anxiety. I have one last post-op appointment, and then after that, it's just randomly meeting with my endocrinologist to make sure my thyroid levels are okay. And then, like, I think a yearly ultrasound to make sure that, you know, nothing has grown back or anything like that. Well, I have some pizza today, and I have one of these little sundae things. I really should not be eating either of these things, you'll especially understand when I talk more about stuff, but I really just wanted to decompress and just make a video, eat some crap food, and then, like, that's it. I really have to start getting back on taking better care of myself. I have been losing weight on my thyroid medication, so that's great, but I need to keep going. But, so, for those of you that don't know, back in January, I was having breathing issues. I thought I had COVID, I didn't. I ended up in the emergency room twice. The first emergency room was just one of those, like, retail, I call it a retail one, a retail emergency room. And then I went to the real emergency room at the hospital. You know, after testing my heart and all kinds of other expensive tests, we ruled out anything to do with my heart or anything like that. And, like, you know, I mentioned the nodule in my thyroid that I've had for years. Out of a last-ditch effort to figure out why I couldn't breathe, I really didn't think that was it, because it hadn't bothered me ever. When I was pregnant with my son, you know, many years ago in, like, 2003, is when they first found it. But anyway, long story short, suggested a biopsy. I had the biopsy in May. It came back as papillary thyroid cancer, like, within 10 minutes. But they had their own team that goes over the biopsy results, like, right then and there. I met with a surgeon, like, 2 weeks later. Actually, no, it was a week later. Suggested a full thyroidectomy, and then they did a biopsy on my nodules. No, I'm sorry, they did a biopsy on my lymph nodes, and decided that they needed to come out too. So on June 10th, I had a total thyroidectomy and neck dissection. My scar goes kind of like a hook. So they took a lot of stuff out. And this whole thing has been really rough on my anxiety. It's been like, it's hit everything that I have issues with. Not being able to breathe, feeling like I'm choking, gagging, like this right here, this area. Ever since I was a kid, I've had issues with it. My neck is so sensitive that, like, as a kid, I could never wear necklaces or, like, pull over hooded sweatshirts, and, like, pressing on that area would make me throw up. I don't know. and it's probably just things in there pulling around and healing and stuff. But it's been really, really difficult to function sometimes. Some days I don't feel it. Some days, like just turning my head or sitting upright, I feel like I'm gonna gag and throw up. It's most prominent in the morning. Unfortunately, a lot of doctor's appointments are in the morning. So I have experienced a lot of anxious, dry heaving before I've had appointments. So this area right here that I'm touching is still numb from the surgery. And my shoulder is still numb, and my back right in that area is still numb. And right here on this side, the back of my head is still numb. And the worst part is that even though it's numb, it still itches. Like it feels like mosquitoes bit it, and you scratch it and you don't get any relief. It sucks. And unfortunately, it's possibly permanent. It could come back in a year or so, but it could be nerve damage from the position that you're in during the surgery. Like, they squish your arm at your side really hard, and like, they have to restrain you so that you don't move under anesthesia. And like, you know, my head was craned back like that, and just apparently being in a certain position for like 6 hours straight or something can really mess up your nerves. So yeah, there's been that stuff. I luckily haven't had any issues with my voice sounding different. I can breathe a lot better. Acid reflux has gotten worse. I had acid reflux bad before, and it's gotten worse. This is not a good idea. Let me tell you. It's got some low sugar cranberry juice. And so the next thing that I had to do that really bothered, well, also anesthesia, going under for the surgery, I was like, my biggest fear was the breathing tube, waking up and being able to feel it, feeling like I'm choking and not being able to breathe. I asked so many people, and they all told me, no, you're not awake when they pull that out. Don't worry about it. I swear, I even asked one of the nurses, and they said, no, don't worry about it, you're not awake. Morning of surgery, super anxious, like my husband had to leave, because no matter what he said, it was just like I was snapping at him because I just could not calm myself down, and I was just not in a good way. And the anesthesia people came to give me a drink to calm acid reflux so I wouldn't get sick or like aspirate vomit or whatever, or acid, while they're doing the surgery. And she was explaining the process of anesthesia. And she's like, oh, and then you'll wake up, you'll take a deep breath for me, and then we'll pull out the breathing tube. I think I've told this story before in my last video, I'm not sure, but if you didn't hear it, I lost my shit. I was like, what? I'm gonna be awake. I literally lost my shit and started crying. And she's like, no, yes, I'm sorry, you have to be awake. I need to be able to make sure that you can take a breath by yourself, a deep breath, so I can safely pull it out. Like, I was just like freaking out. And she was like, it's okay, you're not gonna remember it. All of the people that told you that they were asleep, they weren't. They just don't remember it. I didn't believe her. And then they took me into the room and they knocked me out. Next thing I remember was somebody feeding me ice chips. So I did not remember. And then I thought she was full of crap. Until I heard, like, across from me, this was like a big recovery area. And across from me, they kept trying to wake somebody up. And he kept like gurgling and moaning and stuff, like he was like not really with it. They tried for like 40 minutes. And then finally, like, he took a deep breath and they pulled it out. And then he was quiet. And then 5 minutes later, he woke up and he didn't remember any of it. Okay, so anyway, after that, I had post-op appointments. And the gagging made it really hard to get to those. And last week, on Thursday, I went into the hospital and I took the radioactive iodine pill. Sometimes you take a pill, sometimes you drink a liquid, and it makes you radioactive, and you have to be isolated. And what it does is it goes to any tissue that's left over, and it's like a tax. I don't know, that's how they explained it to me. It basically treats any cancer that might be left over in tissue that they did not get during the surgery. And I was really afraid of that at first because I've heard horror stories of people that took the pill and their throat, like, got really swollen, and they had to go to the ER because their throat closed up, and like extreme vomiting and like swollen jaw, because the radioactive iodine, it goes in there and it destroys your saliva glands. In fact, they suggest sucking on sour candy after you've had taken the pill. But I stayed in the hospital for one night, and they gave me a huge jug of distilled water. And my job was to drink, well, it was a gallon. My job was to drink that gallon of distilled water and drink pee the entire night that I was there. I had never had distilled water before. That stuff tastes like when you blow up a pool float. So gross. So gross. Now, when I got there to the room after I took the pill, a guy came in with a Geiger counter, and I was at a 7, I guess. I don't really know about those type of measurements, but I was at a 7, and he told me that as long as I was under a 6 the next day, I could go home. I made it my job to drink actually confirmed that I was right, that it was my nodule that was causing the breathing issues. Like, I had one huge nodule right here, one right next to it, and then one over here, and they were basically squishing and displacing my trachea. So that's why I was having breathing issues. But anyway, as short as the CT scan was, and it also was not like, it was a more open CT scan. It was like a donut, but you still had to go in the tube a little bit. Hated it. Absolutely hated it. And they made me wear my mask. So it's like, one, I couldn't breathe well as it was. Two, I had the mask on. Three, they make you hold your breath, take a breath, hold your breath, take a breath. I'm just like, no. So I was terrified. But this whole body scan is different. It's very open. You're just on like a table, and like this big, like rectangle camera imaging thing drops down like right above you. It's like not quite touching your nose, but if you tilted your head up, you would hit your head on it. And it sits there, right there for 20 minutes. Scans this area, and then when that's done, it slowly moves down and for 10 minutes scans your stomach and your chest. And it's still claustrophobic with that thing like right there. Hold on, please. I hear a cat. And I was prescribed some diazepam, or however you say it. So I've never taken an Uber before, and I had to take an Uber to this appointment, so I was kind of double nervous. I mean, the Uber ride was fine, it was whatever, but you know, I got to the hospital and I took the pill because it was like 45 minutes before the appointment. The pill did not help me because 10 minutes later, I threw it up. I was just so nervous and out of control with my anxiety. And when it came time for them to take me in, I was like, oh, just so you know, I'm feeling claustrophobic, nauseous, really anxious, you know? And he's like, oh, okay. Poor guy. And just when he had gotten everything set up, oh, I'm not even whispering now. Just when he had gotten everything set up, and the camera had started and it had been a minute, I totally freaked out and he had to stop the machine. He let me drink some water and then he put a cold cloth on my forehead, and then I was able to suck it up and get through the rest of the scan. The nuclear medicine doctor looked at the scan and said that the radioactive iodine went where it needed to go. And that now, other than my post-op with my surgeon's assistant, it's my last post-op. After that, I'll just be meeting with my endocrinologist every now and then. And then I guess every year I'll have like an ultrasound to make sure that nothing is like what it boils down to is getting my blood sugar under control and losing weight. And he said, you know, you don't have to go like strict keto or something like that, but I really highly suggest that given your situation, you really watch your carbohydrates and your sugar. So after this little, after this little junk, I got a bunch of, you know, meat, egg, fruit, vegetables, well, like fruit, like berries and stuff like that. Basically, like, kind of like low, like livable, lower carb stuff. Not super excited about it, but I'm also like at the point where it's like weight loss isn't just about looking better,